Suddenly the stars came down to earth and the panorama of a city burst upon our view in a blaze of lights. And just as the Kremlin clock tower was chiming the midnight hour, our plane made a perfect four-point landing and taxied to a stop. We were in Moscow. So this was journey's end for the 15 travelers from India. Film stars and producers and composers and technicians, all of us on our first visit to the Soviet Union. Did I say journey's end? No, it was only the beginning. The beginning of 30 days of generous hospitality and warm friendship, which even on that night at the airport manifested itself in flowers and flowers and flowers and in smiling, cheering crowds. Mr. Kuzakov, the head of the cinema department, welcomed us on behalf of the Ministry of Culture and said that the arrival of the film delegation from India was sure to bring the friendly peoples of India and the Soviet Union still closer to each other. In my reply, I expressed our gratitude for the flowers that had been given to us and recalled that in the Soviet Union as well as in India, friends are always welcomed with flowers. These flowers, I said, might fade one day, but the flowers of Indo-Soviet friendship shall always remain fresh and fragrant. All over Moscow to greet the Soviet synagogues. Here is Awara, they call it Pradyaga in Russian. And here is Raj Kapoor, who was soon to get the popular title of Tavarish Pradyaga, Comrade Awara. Nargis, the heroine of Awara. And Radhu Karmakar, who photographed Awara. Bimal Roy, the queen, and his talented team. The heroine Nirupa Roy. The hero Balraj Sahni. Hrishikesh Mukherjee, the editor scenarist. And Saleel Chaudhary, the story writer and composer. Vijay Bhatt, producer-director of Baju Bavra. Chetan Anand, the director of Andhya, they call it Uragan here. Dev Anand, the hero of Andhya and also of Rahi, which has been retitled Ganga here. K.A.Abaaz, producer of Ganga and the writer of Awara. That's me, of course. Anil, Biswas, the composer of Ganga. Jani, distributor of Soviet films in India. We felt so at home that soon Raj and Nargis were made up. And on the sets of Romeo and Juliet, which will be a ballet version of the Shakespeare classic and stars the famous Soviet ballerina Ulanova, they were facing the camera for a color test. And Radhu Karmakar was operating the camera in Moscow as if he was back in the RK studios in Bombay. Meanwhile, the Indian artists were chaperoned to the makeup room by the famous Soviet director Roshal and introduced to Yermolov, the famous Soviet makeup artist for whom Nargis had a question. Can you make my nose like this? But where has Raj disappeared? And who is this? Hunchback of Notre Dame? No, no, Raj. That's not how the girls would like to see you. A palace of culture, where we can meet the wide-awake beauties and princess charming of today, the workers of the Stalin automobile factory. And here come the workers' children to offer us flowers. But they are like flowers themselves.
Thank you.
like the ones we saw in the Tretyakov Art Gallery. Here is Raj, who knows something about painting, being an amateur painter himself, explaining some subtleties of art to Nargis and others. It is an impressive collection of Russian masterpieces of many hundred years, and the themes cover a wide range of subjects, even including glimpses of 19th century India, as in this painting of Vereshchagin. But let us leave this static world of art. It certainly seems the whole of Moscow is here. This should be exciting fun, for we have some ardent football fans among us. And now the exciting match begins. I wish David was here, gave the running commentary. It's a keen and well-balanced game, both teams being almost on the same level. It's a ding-dong battle and the ball is traveling freely from one side to the other. Now it's here and now it's there, and the players are everywhere. There is tremendous excitement in the stands. The visiting team has its own backers to occupy a part of the stadium in a solid phalanx. But now the Soviet forwards are pressing, pressing. There is some brilliant passing. Come on, come on, come on. The crowd roars instructions to their favorite players. The Hungarians are putting up a plucky defense. But the Soviet attack is like a blitzkrieg. Here there is of cinematography. The art department interested some of us. Even keener interest is evinced in the play, specially put up for us by the very talented students of the acting faculty, headed by Mrs. Pijova. Here they are. Everyone is impressed, especially the two ladies. And the young heroine receives affectionate congratulations from Nargis and Nirupa. But meanwhile, where is Raj? It seems the boys of the institute have got hold of him.
As the great man Mr. Lenin has said, that cinema is the greatest weapon to mold your country and to bring about different countries into one. So cinema is the greatest mission for all young men to bring different countries into one fold.
Ваш великий учитель, Ленин, говорил, что кино является могущественнейшим средством, посредством которого можно собрать воедино все народы, установить между ними дружбу и ликвидировать всякие раздоры между ними.
So, I salute to all the young politicians who are doing the great work in this world, the work of peace and friendship, always.
Поэтому я поздравляю и приветствую вас, всех тех, которые будут вносить свой большой вклад в это великое дело, направленное на установление мира и прогресса.
Спасибо. Вы любите меня?
That's Russian for "You love me and I love you." Republics. But live people can be even more interesting than golden statues, especially such charming children. Rajbans Khanna has got another pioneer scarf, and Bimal Roy is making friends with a shy little girl. We could only have a fleeting glimpse of the beautiful pavilions representing the different republics, all built in characteristic national architectural style and filled with exhibits proclaiming the achievements of the Soviet Union in the field of agriculture. Symbolically situated in the center of the exhibition is the mechanization pavilion. For undoubtedly, these machines play a very important part in the phenomenal advances made by Soviet agriculture. There are 1,000 different types of red arrow in northern city. There were many prominent artists and cultural workers of Leningrad present at the station to receive us. and among them our friend Nikolai Cherkasov, the great Soviet actor who endeared himself to many of our people when he came to India. Welcoming us to his city, Cherkasov said that though Leningrad was known for its cold, foggy weather, the sun had come out that morning especially to greet the visitors from sunny India. Even if the weather got colder, he assured us, the hearts of the people of Leningrad would be warm for their Indian friends. He preceded us to Leningrad, and our own posters greeted us on our way from the station. In October 1917, behind the Winter Palace, one can see the broad Neva River flowing down to the sea. Come on, let's have a swim, Raj seems to be suggesting to Nargis. And when she shiveringly refuses, now, Raj, please don't be so desperate. Just imagine what these little children will say. Some miles out of Leningrad is Peter Dvoris, the summer palace of Peter, which is certainly the world's most beautiful fountains. It irresistibly reminds the visitor from India of the Mughal gardens of Nishat and Shalimar in Kashmir. This whole place was destroyed by the Nazis during the war. This is one of the practical jokes of Peter the Great. Now, Raj, let's see if you can get out without getting wet. The Hermitage. From Italy and France and Holland and Spain and many other countries, including China and India, and of course, the finest specimens of Russian art, in which lives on all that was best and most beautiful in the old culture of Russia. And here we are in the past. Could it be that a painting in the Hermitage has suddenly come to life? No. It's a scene from the film on the life of Lomonosov, the 18th century scientist who was in film studio is no exception. But let's not disturb them further. So, goodbye, comrades. Tread carefully now. We are in the jungle and I hear the growl of a tiger. Look out, young man. This beast is dangerous. Ah, the beauty and the beast. Plucky young lady, this Ludmila. Namaste, namaste. When artist meets artist, there is neither east nor west. Indian cinema and Soviet cinema. Shake hands and embrace each other in the shape of Pavel Kadochnikov and Dev Anand. We are on the sets of an interesting circus film they are making with a title that has a special appeal for India. It is called Five Tigers. From the banks of the Neva to the banks of the Volga. Stalingrad, they call it the hero city. For never before in human history has any one city endured so much in a war or shown such remarkable collective courage in the face of the enemy. We are placing flowers on one of the many war memorials. Minute silence in honor of the dead who are not dead, whose heroism in the cause of their country has made them immortal. Because here, on this Mamayev Hill, on the bank of the Volga, that the final terrible battle for Stalingrad was fought. Hitler's army suffered their first great defeat here. After 11 years, we can still pick up shell splinters from the ground. This earth was full of so much steel that for several years after the war, no grass would grow on this hill of death. But out of the ruins and rubble of war, out of such unparalleled total destruction, like Phoenix rising from its ashes, a new beautiful Stalingrad is rising. A smiling city of broad avenues and big squares. Tall new buildings, magnificent dwelling houses for the working people. Peace Street, a new city, a happy new future for the children of Stalingrad. This city, which has experienced the deadliest war in human history, has a message for the world. There it is blazoned across the main road, Mir Viru, peace to the world. For instance, is called Maidan-e-Inqilab. And now, we are in the incomparably beautiful Navai Theater, a gem of Uzbek architecture, named after Alisher Navai. These are the robes presented to the delegation by the government of Uzbekistan, according to the age-old tradition of Uzbek hospitality. When you accept such a gift, you are like a brother or a sister. So we cheer and cheer, neither side willing to give up. Many of the Uzbek people are farmers, like Artikov Abdullah, the chairman of the Stalin collective farm near Tashkent.